Now let us see the next example. Here 3 points are given that, and we have to prove that these 3 points forms a collinear. Like such 3 examples are given. Very beginning, what is meant by a collinear? If 2 or more points lie on the same line, such points are said to be collinear. For collinear points, area must be 0. Now, let us verify these are collinear or not. Now, let us come to the first example. Given points are A of 2, 3, B of 4, 0, C of 6, -3. Let us name it x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. That is, for collinear points, you have to find out area. Area formula, delta equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. This is the formula. Now, for collinear points, since given points are, we have to prove that it is a collinear. That is why, let us substitute the values. Delta is equal to half modulus x1 2 times, y2 0 minus y3 minus half minus 3 plus x2 4 times, y3 minus 3 minus y1 3 plus x3 6 times, 3 minus y2 0. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 2 times 0 plus 3 plus 4 times minus 6 plus 6 times 3. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 2 into 3 6 minus 24 plus 6 threes are 18. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 6 plus 18 24 minus 24. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 0. Therefore, delta is equal to 0. That is, what we understand, that is, for collinear points, area must be 0. Therefore, A of 2, 3, B of 4, 0, C of 6, -3 are collinear. Now, let us come to second one. Given points are A of 7, -2, B of 5, 1, C of 3, 4. That is, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. Now, delta is equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. Now, let us check the formula whether it is in the cyclic or not. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2. Yes, given formula is cyclic. Now substitute the values. Half modulus, x1 7 times, y2 1 minus, y3 nothing but 4. x2 5 times, y3 4 minus, y1 minus 2 plus x3 3 times, y1 minus 2 minus y2 is the 1. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 7 times minus 3, 5 times 4 plus 2 plus 3 times minus 2 minus 1 minus 3. That is, delta is equal to half modulus minus 21 plus 5 times 6 minus into minus minus plus into minus minus 3 3 is 9. That is, delta is equal to half modulus minus 21 minus 9 minus 30 plus 5 6 are 38. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 0. Therefore, delta is equal to 0. If delta is equal to 0, therefore, I conclude that A of 7 comma minus 2, B of 5 comma 1, C of 3 comma 4 are collinear. Now, let us come to third example. Given points are x of 5 comma minus 2, y of 6 comma 4, z of 7 comma minus 2. These are the given points. Let us give the name of these points. x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. Now, delta equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. Now, let us check given formula is cyclic or not before going to substitute. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2. That is, delta is equal to half modulus x1 5 times, y2 4 minus, y3 is minus 2 plus x2 6 times, y3 is a minus 2 minus y1 minus 2 plus x3 7 times, y1 minus 2 minus y2 is a 4. Now, delta equal to half modulus 5 times 4 plus 2 plus 6 times minus 2 plus 2 plus 7 times minus 6. Now, delta equal to half modulus 5 times 6 plus 6 into minus 2 plus 2, 0. Now, plus into minus minus 7, 6 are 42. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 30 minus 42. that is delta is equal to half modulus minus 12. Here modulus represents the absolute value of a number, that is absolute value of minus 12 is plus 12. Delta is equal to half into 12, that is delta is equal to 6 square units. Therefore x of 5 comma minus 2, y of 6 comma 4, z of 7 comma minus 2 are not collinear. Why it is not collinear? Since area is not equals to 0, area is a particular real number, that is why if it is a 0, we conclude that it is a collinear. Let us see our next example. Find the value of the k if the following points are collinear. Now a of b of c of, these three points forms a collinear, then you have to find the value of the k. Similarly in the second one, in the third one, very beginning we have to note that for collinear points, for collinear points delta must be 0, that is for collinear points delta is equal to 0. What is the delta? Area of the triangle must be equal to 0, that is a of 2 comma k, b of 4 comma 0, c of 6 comma minus 3. X1 y1, x2 y2, x3 y3, that is delta is equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. Now let us check whether the given are cyclic or not. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2. Yes, it is a cyclic. Now delta is equal to 0. Why equal to 0? For collinear points, delta must be 0. Now half modulus x1 2 times, y2 0 minus, y3 minus 3 plus x2 4 times, y3 minus 3 minus y1 k plus x3 6 times, y1 k minus y2 0. That is 2 will be transferred to the other side, that is 0 is equal to modulus of 2 times minus into minus plus 3 plus open the bracket with the 4. 4 into minus 3 minus 12 plus into minus minus 4 into k 4k plus 6k, because 0 has no value, 6 into k 6k, that is 0 is equal to modulus of 2 3s are 6 minus 12 minus 4k plus 6k, that is plus 2k. Now 0 equal to modulus of 2k, 6 minus 12, that is a minus 6. Now since k value is a positive, now we have to remove from the modulus, that is 2k minus 6 is equal to 0, 2k equal to 6, k is equal to 6 by 2, therefore k k is equal to 3. Therefore, k is equal to, the value of k is equal to 3. Similarly, come to the second question. Given points are a of 7 comma minus 2, b of 5 comma k, and c of 3 comma 4. Now, x1 y1, x2 y2, x3 y3. Now, for collinear points, delta must be 0. For collinear points, delta must be 0. That is, delta equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. That is, delta value must be 0. Since given points are collinear, he already said that is the delta value must be 0. Half modulus x1 7 times, y2 k minus, y3 is a 4 plus, x2 5 times, y3 4 minus, y1 minus 2 plus, x3 3 times, y1 minus y2 minus 2 minus y2 nothing but k. Now, since 2 is transferred to the LHS, 0 into 2, that is equal to 0 modulus of, open the brackets, 7k minus 7 fours are 28 plus 5 times 4 plus 2 plus, open the bracket with 3, 3 into minus 2 minus 6 minus 3k, that is 0 is equal to modulus of 7k minus 3k, that is 4k minus 28 plus 5 times 6 minus 6, that is 0. Now here itself, 0 is equal to 4k minus 28 minus 6, that is minus 34 plus 30, that is 0 is equal to modulus of 4k minus 34 plus 30, that is minus 4. Now, 4k minus 4 equal to 0, 4k equal to 4, k is equal to 1. Therefore, the value of k equals to 1. Well, come to the third question. Answer to C. Given points are x of 5 comma minus 2, y of 6 comma 4, z of 7 comma k, that is x1 y1, x2 y2 and x3 y3. We know that for collinear points, delta equals to 0. For collinear points, delta equals to 0. That is, delta equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. That is, let us check whether it is cyclic or not. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2. That is, for collinear points, the area must be 0, we know well. 0 is equal to half modulus x1 5 times, y2 4 minus, y3 k plus x2 6 times, y3 k minus, y1 minus 2 plus x3 7 times, y1 minus 2 minus y2 4. Now 2 is transferred to the other side, that will becomes 0. 0 is equal to modulus of 5 into 4 20 minus 5 into k 5k plus 6 times k plus 2 plus 7 times minus 6 minus 2 minus 4, that is equal to minus 6. 0 is equal to modulus of 20 minus 5k plus 6 into k 6k plus 6 2s are 12 minus 7 6 are 42. Now that is, 0 is equal to, first of all let us simplify the k value. Plus 6k minus 5k, that is a k. Now positive values, 20 plus 12 32, minus 42. 0 is equal to modulus of k minus 32 plus 32 minus 42, that is minus 10. That is, k minus 10 equal to 0, that is k is equal to 10. Therefore the value of k must be equals to 10. Let us see the next example. If a of minus 5 comma 7, b of minus 4 comma minus 5, c of minus 1 comma minus 6 and d of 4 comma minus 4 comma 5 are the vertices of a quadrilateral, find the area of the quadrilateral ABCD. Now let us draw the diagram. A of minus 5 comma 7, b of minus 4 comma minus 5, c of minus 1 comma minus 6 and d of 4 comma 5. Let us check the vertices one more time. A of minus 5 comma 7, b of minus 4 comma minus 5, c of minus 1 comma minus 6 and d of 4 comma 5. Now we know very well, diagonal AC divides a quadrilateral ABCD into two parts, that is part 1 and part 2. We have to find out these two parts separately. Now let us follow. given a of minus 5 comma 7, b of minus 4 comma minus 5, c of minus 1 comma minus 6. Are the vertices of quadrilateral ABCD. Now, case 1, that is area of triangle ABC, that is we are going to find the area of triangle ABC first. Let us take A of minus 5 comma 7, B of minus 4 comma minus 5, C of minus 1 comma minus 6, that is x1 y1, x2 y2, x3 y3. Now delta is equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1, x3 into y1 minus y2. Delta is equal to half modulus x1 1 2 3 2 3 1 3, 1, 2. Yes, these are in cyclic. Now substitute the values. X1 minus 5 times, Y2 minus 5 minus Y3 plus 6 plus, because minus into minus plus. X2 minus 4 into y3 minus 6 minus y1 7 plus x3 minus 1 into y1 7, y2 minus into minus plus 5. That is the delta is equal to half modulus minus 5 times 1. Minus 5 plus 6 is the 1, minus 4 into minus 6 minus 7 minus 13, plus into minus, minus 1 into 7 plus 5, that is a 12. Now delta is equal to half modulus minus 5 minus into minus plus 4 into 13, 52, minus 12. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 52 minus 5 minus 12 minus 17. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 12 minus 7 5, here 1 is a borrowed, that is 4 minus 1, 3. That is, delta is equal to, if you divide by 2, 17.5 square units will come. That is, therefore, area of triangle ABC equal to 17.5 square units. Similarly, come to the second part. Case 2. Case 2. Area of triangle ACD. A, C, D. There is a second part. That is area of A of minus 5 comma 7, C of minus 1 comma minus 6, D of 4 comma 5. A, C, D. X1, Y1, X2, Y2 and X3, Y3. Now, delta is equal to half modulus X1 into Y2 minus Y3 plus X2 into Y3 minus Y1 plus X3 into Y1 minus Y2. That is, delta is equal to half modulus x1 minus 5 into y2 minus y3, that is y2 value is the minus 6 minus y3 is the 5. Now before going to substitute, once again we have to check whether these are cyclic or not. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1. 3, 1, 2. Yes, these are cyclic. X2 plus X2 is the minus 1 into Y3 5 minus Y1 7 plus X3 4 times Y1 7 minus Y2 is plus 6. Here, between y1 and y2, minus sign is there, but y2 is a minus 6, minus into minus plus 6. Now, delta is equal to half modulus minus 5 times minus 11, minus 6 minus 5 minus 11, plus into minus, minus 1 into 5 minus 7, that is a 2, plus 4 times 7 plus 6, that is 13. That is, delta is equal to half modulus minus into minus plus 5 11 is 55 minus 2 plus 52. 4 into 13, that is 52. Now, delta is equal to half modulus 55 minus 2 plus 52, that is plus 50. Minus 2 plus 52, that is a plus 50. That is, delta is equal to 1 by 2 into modulus of 105. That is, therefore, delta is equal to 2 table 105, that is 52.5 square units. That is, from this, now after this we have to find out area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ACD. We have to add the both. That is, area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to area of triangle ABC is 17.5 plus, now area of triangle ACD is 52.5. Now that is equal to, in the margin side you have to add the both, 17.5, 52.5. 5 plus 5, 10, 7 plus 2, 9 plus 1, 10, 5, 6, 7, that is 70 square units. Therefore, area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to 70 square units. Let us see the next example. If A of 5 comma 4, B of 3 comma 8, C of minus 1 comma 6 and D of 1 comma 2 are the vertices of a square, find the area of the square ABCD. Previously, just we find out how to find the area of the quadrilateral. That is, in quadrilateral, diagonal divides the quadrilateral into two triangles. After that, we find out the area of the triangle 1 and we find out the area of the triangle 2. After that, area of triangle 1 plus area of triangle 2 will give us area of the quadrilateral ABCD. But here, the given one is the square. Now, let us see. A of 5 comma 4, B of 3 comma 8, C of minus 1 comma 6 and D of 1 comma 2 are the vertices of a square. We know that in square all angles are right angles and diagonal divides the square into two triangles of equal area. That is, in square ABCD, diagonal AC divides into two triangles. Two triangles of equal area. That is, area of triangle ABC, area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle ADC. We have noted down that these two are equal. That is, this is the part 1, this is the part 2. Now, let us consider case 1. Area of triangle ABC, we have to find out. That is, A of 5 comma 4, B of 3 comma 8, C of minus 1 comma 6. That is, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. Now, delta is equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. Let us check whether these are cyclic or not. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1 and 3, 1, 2. Yes, these are cyclic. Now, arrange these values. Half modulus, x1 5 times, y2 8 minus, y3 is a 6 plus x2 is a 3, y3 6 minus, y1 4 plus x3 minus 1 into y1 4 minus y2 8. That is delta is equal to half modulus 5 times 8 minus 6 2 plus 3 times 6 minus 4 2 plus into minus minus 1 into 4 minus 8 minus 4. That is delta is equal to half modulus 5 2s 10 plus 3 2s 6 minus into minus plus 4. That is delta is equal to half modulus 20. Therefore, area of triangle ABC is equal to 10 square units. Now, according to the given question, area of triangle ABC and ADC both are same. Therefore, area of triangle ADC is also 10 square units. Now, let us confirm, we will verify that. Case 2. Area of triangle ADC, A of 5 comma 4, D of 1 comma 2, C of minus 1 comma 6. That is x1 y1, x2 y2 and x3 y3. That is delta is equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. Let us check the cyclic order. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2. That is delta is equal to half modulus x1 5 times y2 minus y3 2 minus 6, x2 1 times y3 6 minus 4 plus x3 minus 1 into y1 4 minus y2, that is a 2. Now delta is equal to half modulus 5 times minus 4 plus 1 into 2 plus into minus minus 1 into 2. That is delta is equal to half modulus minus 20 plus 2 minus 2. Both will cancel. That is delta equal to half into modulus of minus 20. That is delta is equal to half into modulus of a real number is never negative. Therefore, modulus of minus 20 is 20. Therefore, area of triangle ADC is equal to 10 square units. Therefore, very beginning we conclude that in square, the diagonal divides the square into two triangles of equal area. Therefore, area of triangle ABC is the 10 square unit and area of triangle ADC is also 10 square unit. Therefore, we conclude that area of square ABCD is equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ADC. ABC plus ADC, that is equal to area of square ABCD is equal to 10 plus 10. Therefore, area of square ABCD is equal to 20 square units. Let us see the next example. Find the area of the triangle formed by joining the midpoints of sides of the triangle whose vertices are 0, minus 1, 2, 1 and 0, 3. Find the ratio of this area of the given triangle. Now, let us consider the triangle now, A of 0, minus 1, B of 2, 1, C of 0, 3. Now, find the area of the triangle formed by joining the midpoints of the sides. Now, let us look at the midpoints. Now, D, E, F. Answer, let A of 0, minus 1, B of 2, 1, C of 0, 3 are the vertices of triangle ABC. Let D, E, F are the midpoints of sides. Now D is the midpoint of BC, E is the midpoint of AC, and F is the midpoint of AB respectively. Now we have to find out the values of D, E, F. We know D is midpoint of BC. That is BC. B of 2, 1, C of 0, 3. Now D is the midpoint. That is x1, y1, x2, y2. D of x, y is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. That is D of x, y is equal to x1 2 plus 0 by 2, 1 plus 3 by 2. D of x, y is equal to 2 by 2, comma 4 by 2. That is D of x, y is equal to 1, comma 2. Now, the value of the D is 1, comma 2. Now, we can write similarly E of E is the midpoint of AC. Now we can find out this value directly. How see? 0 plus 0, 0 by 2, there is a 0. Minus 1 plus 3, there is a 2, 2 by 2, 1. Now E value is 0 comma 1. Now F is the midpoint of AB. Now how to find this value? Let us see. 0 plus 2, 2 by 2, 1. Minus 1 plus 1, 0. 0 by 2 is a 0. That is F value is 1 comma 0. Now I am ready with the values of D, E, F. Now first find area of triangle ABC. Case 1. Area of triangle ABC, that is A of 0 comma minus 1, B of 2 comma 1, C of 0 comma 3. X1 Y1, X2 Y2, X3 Y3. That is delta is equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. Now delta is equal to 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1 and 3, 1, 2. Yes, it is in cyclic order. Now 1 by 2 into modulus x1 0 times y2 1 minus y3 is a 3. x2 2 times y3 3 minus y1 minus into minus plus 1 plus x3 0 into y1 minus y2, that is minus 1 minus 1. That is delta is equal to half modulus 0 into any number 0 plus 2 times 3 plus 1, that is a 4, plus 0 into any number, that is a 0. That is delta is equal to half modulus 2 fours are 8. That is, therefore, area of triangle ABC is equal to 2 table 8 4 times. That is 4 square units. Area of triangle ABC is 4 square units. Now, case 2. Case 2 we have to find. Case 2, area of triangle DEF, that is D of 1 comma 2, E of 0 comma 1, F of 1 comma 0, X1 Y1, X2 Y2, X3 Y3. Now delta is equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. That is delta is equal to half modulus x1 1 into y2 1 minus y3 0 plus x2 0 into y3 0 minus y1 2 plus x3 1 into y1 2 minus y2 1. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 1 times 1 plus 0 into any number 0 plus 1 times 1. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 1 plus 1. Delta is equal to 1 by 2 into modulus 2. That is equal to 1 square unit. Therefore, area of triangle DEF is equal to 1 square units. Now, here we have to compare area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF is equal to area of triangle ABC is 4 square units by area of triangle DEF is 1 square unit. That is, therefore, area of triangle ABC, therefore, area of triangle ABC is to area of triangle DEF is equals to 4 is to 1. That is, what we conclude from this one is, if DEF are the midpoints of sides of triangle ABC, then area of triangle ABC to the area of the triangle formed by the midpoints of the sides is in the ratio 4 is to 1. Let us see our next example. Verify that median of a triangle divides it into two triangles of equal area. If A of 4 comma minus 6, B of 3 comma minus 2, C of 5 comma 2 are the vertices of triangle ABC. Now, let us see. A of 4 comma minus 6, B of 3 comma minus 2, C of 5 comma 2 are the vertices of triangle ABC. Now, let us join the midpoint of side BC is AD. Now, join AD. Now, AD is the median of triangle ABC. Given A of 4 comma minus 6, B of 3 comma minus 2, C of 5 comma 2 are the vertices of triangle ABC. Now, let D is midpoint of BC. Now, B of 3 comma minus 2, C of 5 comma 2. Now, we have to find out the value of D, but D is the midpoint. Now, D is equal to formula x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. That is x1 y1 x2 y2. That is D is equal to x1 3 plus 5 by 2 minus 2 plus 2 by 2. That is D is equal to 8 by 2, 0 by 2. That is D is equal to 4 comma 0. Now, the value of the D is 4 comma 0. Now, you have to show that triangle 1 and triangle 2 are equal in area. Now you have to verify whether they are equal or not. Now, first case. Case 1. Case 1. Area of triangle ABD. Area of triangle ABD. A of 4 comma minus 6, B of 3 comma minus 2, D of, third option is a D of 4 comma 0. X1 Y1, X2 Y2, X3 Y3. That is, delta is equal to half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3, x2 into y3 minus y1, plus x3 into y1 minus y2. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 4 times minus 2 minus 0, x2 3 times y3 0 plus 6, x3 plus 4 times y1 minus y2 minus 6 plus 2, because y2 is minus 2 minus into minus plus. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 4 times minus 2 plus 3 times 6 plus 4 times minus 4. That is, delta is equal to half modulus minus 8 plus 18 minus 16. That is, delta is equal to half modulus 18 minus 24. That is, delta is equal to half modulus of minus 6. That is, delta is equal to half into 6. That is equal to 3 square units. Therefore, area of triangle ABD is equal to 3 square units.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.